Going from horses to cars was a big change, but these days, nobody's talking about the cost of pay. Fuel costs and charging are important for EV buyers, but today, we're covering five other differences between electric and gas cars. Hey everybody, I'm Desola from Edmonds, where we're known as the car testing pros. We've teamed up with the experts over at CarMax to help you find the right car for your needs. So let's start at the front. Now, without a big engine under the hood, there's a little extra space that can be turned into extra storage space, and that's called a frunk, a front trunk. You get it? And it's actually a really nice bonus for EV owners. I mean, come on, who doesn't love extra storage space? But one thing you should know is that all frunks are not created equal. This F-150 has a frunk that's almost as big as the trunk on a Honda Civic. But the F-150 is large, and electric cars still need a space for things like power inverters, battery cooling, the AC compressor, and heating, all of which still go under the hood. So if you're going with a smaller EV, you'll end up with a smaller frunk. But I mean, look at this. This is ridiculous. So on smaller EVs, you get smaller frunks. The IONIQ 5 gets just 2 cubic feet under the hood. And if you opt for one with all-wheel drive like this one, it's not just less than half the space, it's this shape. Gas cars like this one use more mechanical parts than electric cars, like big bulky transmissions and long drive shafts. You know, EVs are just mechanically simpler, so they're able to skip all these big and bulky parts. A lot of EVs are built in a way that kind of looks like the body is attached to a big flat skateboard. That means big flat floors like these, and honestly, it is so cool. Now, were you the kid that always got stuck in the middle seat? Thanks to electric cars, other kids won't have to suffer the way you did. It does mean that if you drop your water bottle, it can roll all the way away. But EV architecture can open up extra foot room or storage space. Over the air or OTA updates are software updates that are delivered to your car through wireless data connection, the same way your cell phone gets updated with new features. And they're actually becoming pretty common now. Even gas powered cars get over the air updates. Whether a feature is part of a free or paid update is up to the manufacturer. Now the upside is that you may be able to get access to features introduced after your car was built, like a new voice assistant or improved driver's aids. The downside is that you may wind up paying a bit extra to use some features that traditionally would have been covered by the vehicle's original purchase price. Free or paid, not all updates are created equal. In most gas cars, over-the-air updates are limited to things like infotainment. Now, some electric cars can update just about everything. Without all the oily mechanical bits limiting what software alone can do, software updates can change how an EV drives, like the feel of braking and acceleration, or how the steering responds. And those changes add up to the point where they can even affect your car's estimated range. So the idea is that with so much freedom to adjust things, manufacturers can keep your car feeling fresh longer, and they can even address issues without you having to leave your house. Don't panic. When we talk about one-pedal driving, we're not talking about a car with one pedal. Electric cars still have an accelerator and a brake, just like you used to. One-pedal driving may sound a little strange. Instead of coasting like you would in a gasoline car, you brake without even touching the brake pedal. In practice, it turns your gas pedal into more of a speed selector than an accelerator. See, electric cars can recapture energy while slowing down, using the motors as generators. In a lot of electric cars, this regenerative braking can be surprisingly strong and can even slow your car all the way down to a stop without ever needing the physical brakes. There's usually an option to switch between regular driving and one-pedal driving. When one-pedal driving is on, the car uses regenerative braking to slow down as soon as you take your foot off the gas pedal. And yes, the brake lights do turn on. You can still use your brakes for extra stopping power. And in most electric cars, if you turn off one-pedal driving, you'll still use regenerative braking first when you apply the brakes. But one-pedal driving can help you drive more smoothly and economically, and it lets you know you're recapturing the maximum possible amount of energy. One thing electric cars have a lot more of is quiet. I mean, the only thing you can hear right now is the AC. Gas engines make a lot of noise, and the thing about it is you don't really realize it until, well, there isn't any. And with that said, you also won't really have a reference of how fast you're going. So when you're driving, just make sure to pay attention to your speedometer. It also means that you're gonna notice a lot of other noises in an EV. For example, electric cars are required by law to emit an artificial sound at low speeds to warn pedestrians that you're nearby. And different brands have gone for different sounds. There are lots of other noises that can be more noticeable without the sound of a gas engine to cover them up. So while EVs are generally quieter than gas cars, you'll be getting used to a slightly different soundtrack. There's a lot to think about when considering an EV, and we've covered it. What are the maintenance costs? Do I need to worry about range? And how much does it cost to charge? There are also other differences and perks to EVs, but none quite as good as not having to shovel hay every day. If you have any other questions about EVs, make sure to comment down below. As cars continue to evolve, we'll be right here to keep you informed. Make sure to like and subscribe, and of course, click the link in the bio for an in-depth article.